Hello. So what we're going to do now is we're going to do the Marcelo Monreal walkthrough. I'm going to teach you how to cut flowers out, how to place them onto a background, and how to cut a celebrity's face out. So don't forget, this is obviously going to be a lot better using your own photography, but I'm just going to use celebrities just because it's a lot easier for now. So first of all, look at the PowerPoint, realize how you cut the face out, then you put tile in the background, add the flowers, and then add the colour, and then it should turn out a little bit something like that. And obviously you can add whatever spin you want on it. So I've got Messi with all of the trophies that he's won, which is an absolute boatload. So we're going to start off by just looking at how to cut the face out. So that is a really easy one. First of all, you're going to go, I don't know, type in celebrity portraits, pick whichever celebrity you want. It's nice to pick a black and white one if you want like really, really contrasting colours, or if you don't want contrasting colours and you just want a colour one, then you know, choose a colour one, have the flowers pouring out. So that's quite a cool one. What we're going to do, in fact, I'm going to choose that one because it's a bigger face, so I can cut a larger section off. So I'm just going to copy the image, go onto Photoshop, open a new document, and then using this, what we're going to do, get rid of that, we're going to choose the bottom layer, and we are quite simply just going to grab the lasso tool, zoom in on the area that you want to cut. You see, I'm just going to cut this like that. So you want nice smooth curves, and then just like Marcelo Monreal, I'm going to go around the nose. Little bit of a jump there where the lips are. Try and follow the jawbone if you can. And then when you go back to the beginning, you should leave a selection like so. Alright, making sure that you are on the layer that you want to cut. What we're going to do is we're going to hold Control and C and Control and V, and that will create a brand new layer there. So if I just cancel that layer out, we can see what I've done there. And now that we've done that, we're just going to move it to the side and we're going to do it all over again. And the reason that we're doing it all over again is because this is now going to be the hole. So we're going to actually delete this one. And then that way all the flowers will come out of the hole and they'll poke through the celebrity face. Okay, so holding, making sure that you're on the right layer as well. So you don't want to delete a part of that layer. So holding Control and X, which creates cut, and you can see that I've kind of cut the face off there. It's not exact, but once that's there and all the flowers are pouring out, you won't really be able to see that. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go onto Google, type in patterned tile botanical, and then I'm just going to grab that. Control and T. Give me 2 seconds, my computer is just frozen. Now I'm just going to drop that underneath the other layers, so you can see that the tile is now underneath. Just need to make it a little bit bigger. Cool. So now I've got the tile underneath. And then, real quick, what you could do is double click on the layer, and then what we're going to do here, look, drop the shadow. Now can you see? It's just a slight bit of shadow coming off that. You see? It's coming off the part of the face that I cut out. Increase the size a little bit. The opacity needs to be right up. Like that. And then what happens is when you hover that over the flowers later on, it's going to add a little bit of shadow on it. Okay. What I'm going to do now to inner glow. Why I've done the inner glow is just so that this stands out a little bit more. And then what you can do, if you want, on top of the tile, to make sure that you're on that layer, you can actually get your brush tool, just your normal brush tool. See how big it is. Normal mode, 100% opacity, and then change this to whatever colour you want. And then have it about there so that it stands out a little bit. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to run it down one side. So if that's coming off that way, then I'm going to make sure that it just slightly comes out like so. There, I'm just going to go back. I'm not on the right brush, and it needs to be a hard round brush. Okay, if it's not a hard round brush, you'll leave a fuzzy background. I'm just going to make sure it's a hard round brush, and I'm just going to create a really nice little simple line there. Zoom in. Make the brush a little bit smaller. And then you want to be on the brush tool. And you just want to follow that edge all the way around. And you can see when I zoom out, it adds to that line. Okay, you can do one or you can do two. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to bring back the face. And you see I've got a face. It's just going to come off like so. Alright, so that is step one. I suppose step 1.5 whilst we're doing this is we might as well do this now as well. So if you zoom right in, what we can do is we can cut multiple shapes out. So I'm going to cut that shape out. And just copy and paste that. It's on a separate layer. And then if we just move it like that, so that we know what shape we're doing. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect, you just have to get that shape-ish, because what we're going to do is we're going to poke loads of flowers out of there. Alright, so now that that's selected, like so, I'm just going to hold Ctrl and press X, oh, on the right layer. So now you can see there's a hole in there. And now put that there. So when we zoom out, you can see it looks like a face. It's coming out again. Alright. What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna do that a couple more times. Chosen the wrong layer again. Can you see that? Really nice and basic. Okay, so that's step one.